following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
Hi everyone, I'm John Latch along with my cameraman Anthony DeMambro. We're here on the road in Hudson, New Hampshire at the 4th Annual Lumberjack Competition, sponsored by the Hudson Historical Society. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Here at the Lumberjack Show, we have Calvin. Calvin, thanks for coming on.
Yeah, you bet.
Where are you from, Calvin?
I'm from Northern Vermont.
Northern Vermont, okay. So what are we doing over here, Calvin? What are you doing here? Are you chopping the wood and stuff?
Yeah, this is one of the events we're doing here today. It's called the Springboard Chop.
Springboard chop, okay.
So what I'm doing right now is prepping the pole. On go, we have to chop a pocket in the bottom of the tree. We place a board in that pocket. We stand on that pocket. Climb up on the board, chop a second pocket, reach down, put our second board in the tree, stand on that board, and then when we're on top, then we chop our block in half.
Okay. So there's only two springboards? Is that the limit to the amount of boards? boards that you can have? Or?
Yep, two boards.
Okay. Yep. Now, are they spaced a certain amount of distance apart, or is it by the rules?
Yeah, everybody spaces them a little bit different apart based on height. But for the most part, we're all roughly 40 inches apart.
Thank you so much for coming on, Calvin. Appreciate it.
Absolutely.
Good shopping. All right, here we go. Timers, clear your watches. Contestants, this is your cadence. 3, 2, 1, go! All right, folks, your favorite, cheer them on. It's not going to take them long. This will be the first guy to climb. Sullivan's up on the board first. They're going to be chasing down the Larry's up there on station number 6. Looks like Anthony and Tyler are the last to climb. They're going to make up for it, though, in this next packet. Who's going to be up first? It is still Sullivan. Sullivan on the top board first. Two hits ahead of Stuart and Uncle Vic. These guys are making it look easy out here right now. You see Sullivan wading through that block up there, making short work of that 10-inch piece of aspen. All right, we got Lombardo over here. Station number 2 is trying to catch up right now. Sullivan's going for the slash. One more hit should do it. There it is. Wow. Winner of the first team, Mike Sullivan. Coming off second there, Drew Jordan. And Jordan coming off third. All right, look. Bodie has made the turn, he's going for the slash. Willard's going for the slash. And Bodie's off fourth. You see folks, Tyler White over here, station number 4. He's got that, everybody else in the seat's kind of had a board that's been sitting upright. You see Tyler, he's been able to get all the weight on that board to get a big, nice swing out of that block. You know, if you get a little bit of a wall of wood in those pockets, those boards won't fit in there correctly. You see what Tyler's like struggling with right there? One or two hits in that pocket might have really helped him out. Could have drastically improved his time on the top of that block. But Chiramani's almost done, folks. He can hear you. There it is. Give him another big round of applause.
We're here at the Lumberjack Show with Ken. Ken, thanks for coming on. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about what's going on over here with these. I see some of these are all marked and stuff. Can you tell us a little bit? Give us
sure.
an overview?
Sure. This is all 10-inch pine.
10-inch pine?
10-inch diameter pine. And this is for sanding block. And what happens is they draw numbers and they number the wood. And so it's random as to what you're getting. So I happen to get number 15. So this is going to be my block for sanding block.
Okay.
Whereas the underhand block is this square wood, it's 10 by 10 for the men. Uh-huh. And I got a number 16 on that one, and I've already got it set up because I'm in the first heat. A lot of it's pine, but a lot of it's popple or aspen. And so it cuts a little bit differently. The aspen tends to be a little harder than the pine, but it'll vary stick to stick also.
Right. Thank you so much for coming on. I appreciate it.
Well, thank you.
So here we have Eric. Eric, thanks for coming on. Appreciate it.
No problem.
Where are you from, Eric?
I'm from Bethlehem, Connecticut.
Bethlehem, Connecticut. Okay. So what are you doing over here, Eric?
We're just getting the sand ready just for the show. I mean, it's the square wood piece of wood, obviously, and it's a round wood stand, so we got to just trim it down to fit it in our setup here.
Right. Now, is there a certain width that the wood has to be? Is it regulated for regulations?
Today it is, yes. It's a 10 by 10 show, so everybody cuts 10-inch wood.
Okay, all right. And obviously somebody stands on the top, right? Is it very slippery sometimes? People kind of slide off? Or?
Sometimes, but like most of the guys in this sport have been doing it for a year, so we're all pretty good at it. Not too many people fall.
Now, is there any cheating, so to speak, where somebody wants to stand on their tippy toes when they're over there on the top of there?
Oh, not really. I mean, like, you don't really get like too much of an advantage.
You don't get too much of an advantage.
Yeah, by standing on your tippy toes, like, you usually get more power by keeping your feet flat. So.
Right. So what do you enjoy about working with wood and stuff?
In this stuff, it's just, competition. Like, that's always fun. And just meeting everybody. Everybody's a good group of guys. It's always a lot of fun. And
so were you here last year?
I was not here last year.
Not here last year? Yeah. So what are some of the competitions you've been to?
Like Boonville, New York, Fryeburg, Maine, like Arrow, New Hampshire.
Right.
Yeah, so.
Good luck.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Tyler. What did you do in this board here? Let me pull that thing out of there. Timers, clear your watches. Contestants, this is your cadence. 3, 2, 1, go! All right, folks, pick your favorite, cheer them on. Got 10 inches of white pine they got to cut through here. You see Jesse cutting, getting those big long strokes out of there, making short work of that white pine over there on station number 5. These competitors, so he's already made the turn. Oh, holy cow, Ryan Ford's gone. He's able to kick him out of the park. I look down there, I'm like, oh, I haven't seen anybody else cut yet. I didn't even get a chance to look at that block. Nice. I know we're going for drivers here. There we go. Fuck, we got the. All right, let's stick with our last couple competitors here. Couple of college guys. One of those guys out of Paul Smith. There he is right there. Didn't get to talk about him much. Let's stick with Wyatt Beaumont, though. He's on stand number 8. Waiting for that block right now. He's got a good rendition of the Stairway to Heaven on this side of the block, and I'll comment on that in a second, folks. He's got a couple more to do. Cheer him on, folks. He can hear ya. Unofficially a time of 22 seconds. Ryan, you want to talk to the crowd a little bit about that car? Please, man.
Okay, here we have Darcy. She's going to be in the women's competition for the cross cut. Competition. Thanks for coming on.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.
Tell us a little bit about your saw here.
It's not my saw, but it's a borrowed saw. Yeah. It's a two-cutter made by J.P. Mercier. Mm-hmm. He also files and like sharpens the saw. I don't remember how long it is, but the length is important because you don't want too long if you're like short or whatever. Anyways.
So where do you get this kind of item here sharpened? Where do you get it sharpened at?
The guy who does it lives up in Canada.
Canada?
Yep. Mm-hmm. So you have to send him up there or go visit him and bring it with you. And it takes him a while, so usually you can drop it off with him and then pick it up later or get it shipped back to him.
So how many years have you been in competition over here?
This is my first year at this show.
First year? Okay.
But I've been competing for like 6 years.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So what are some of the places you've been to?
I'm from Connecticut, so normally I'll go to the little Connecticut State Fairs, and then up in New York they have a big show every year, so I'll go to that one, and then up to Maine in October.
It's obviously something you really enjoy.
Yeah. Yep.
Like, you know? Yeah.
Yes, it is. Great. It's a great sport.
Well, thanks, Darcy. Thanks for coming on. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you.
But if you do that and you don't have that starting cut in there already to keep that saw in the wood, it could skate right off the wood. And at that point, you could put it in your leg, you could put it in the ground. These saws are like $2,000 to $3,000 a piece. So now you start jeopardizing your equipment and your health. You're like, okay, I understand why they have these starting cuts. So all of our contestants are going to get a little bit of a starting curve. I think they're getting about 8 inches right off the top of the rock. Started up, revved up. What do we got here? So, the cutting teeth. We've got a 3-cutter here on station number 2. So, like I was saying, that's 3 cutting teeth for every raking tooth. The 3 cutting teeth will pass through the wood. The raking tooth will take all the wood noodles out of there. We call them noodles. And when we get a couple heaps here, I'll show you guys some noodles. They're like 6 or 7 inches long. They're incredible. It's incredible how much wood these saws can cut with one pass through the wall. All right, pick your favorite, cheer them on. Not going to take them long into the wood here. One cut event, 16 inches of aspen. Timers, clear your watches. Contestants, this is your cadence. 3, 2, 1, go! All right, folks, pick your favorite and cheer them on. We're going to make short work of this 16 inches of white pine out here. Oh, we got it. Is it aspen over there? I think it's a white pine. All right, pick your favorite, cheer them. It's going to be the fun to get into the
I guess they all have a green.
Okay, Mr. Kolesky, bring that saw up. That's the second post. Timers, clear your watches. Contestants, this is your cadence. 3, 2, 1, go! Alright, pick your favorite and cheer them on, folks. Looks like all these ladies really wading through the block right now. Alright, looks like Darcy's down into the small wood now. So is Miller time, but Jess Edwards already done. Followed by Miller on 3. Darcy's got 1 or 2 more strokes to do it there. Heidi McGuire is right with him, and it is both these ladies at the same time. Give them a big round of applause.
Here we have Virginia, who competed in the Bowsaw competition. Virginia, thanks for coming on. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit what you were doing here. You were brushing your blade off.
Yeah.
What actually does that do? I know it cleans it, but...
I was brushing my blade off to clean out any sawdust or any residue from the cut that I made so that I can put it away nice and clean and keep it in tip-top shape.
That if you left it on there, that could actually dull the blade? Is that correct?
It could dull the blade. It could rust the blade. Yeah.
Now, is this your first time coming here on this event? Or?
It's my first time at this particular competition, but I've been competing since 1999 when I started in college. Now I'm dating myself, but.
So what are some of the areas that you've been to, the event?
I've been all over New England. I've been out to Ohio. I competed in the steel timber sports once. I've been to Canada, and I've participated in just about every single event. Springboard is one that I have not done. You don't see women really in that event.
So what do you enjoy about this particular?
This is actually my favorite event other than chainsaw, yeah. Uh-huh. It's just one that I've done fairly well at and I enjoy.
Now I notice when the wood hits the ground, you guys pick it back up again. Do you take a look at where you're cutting as far as your angles and stuff?
We do. We pick up that piece of wood, we call it a cookie, and we look at it to see how the blade cut in that particular piece of wood. We look to see of the condition of the wood. We can tell, you know, whether it was a good piece of wood, a bad piece of wood, if there's any knots. And it's a judgment for our next cut.
Next.
Yep.
Well, thanks, Virginia. Thanks for coming on. I appreciate it.
Oh, thank you.
This is your cadence. 3, 2, 1, go! Alright, pick your favorite cheer on, folks. It's not going to take these ladies long. Wow, all these saws are really flying through the wood. Looks like Kendall's already into the bottom wood there. About to rip that thing off. Who's it going to be through the bottom? And it is Kendall. Followed right behind her, Kelly Kerrigan. That saw looks really aggressive down. Not really the full stroke on it, but there it is. All right.
Okay, here at the show we have Kyler. Kyler, thanks for coming.
No problem. I'm glad to be here.
So is this your first time here at this event, or have you been here before?
This is, I think, my 4th year. I've been coming to the show every year that it's been going on, so we're glad to be here again. Okay. Looking forward to having a good time today.
Okay. So what other events have you been to around the area?
A couple others in New Hampshire, a lot this summer in New York. I went to one in West Virginia in Memorial Day, and I've got one Columbus Day weekend down in Western Pennsylvania. So we travel all over.
So what do you love about the you know, the competition and the sport itself?
It's just fun. There's a lot of camaraderie. Most of my good friends compete, so it's nice to see them almost every weekend. And it's just, we just have fun with it.
Right. Tell us a little bit about your saw here, you know.
It's different from a regular saw.
Yeah, this is definitely different from a regular saw. This started out its life as a 250 KTM dirt bike. And basically you I built this one myself. A lot of guys, some guys buy them, but this one, I bought a bike. Basically, you cut the motor out of it, cut the transmission off, and hook a chainsaw bar to the side of it. And
tell us, Kyler, a lot about safety. I know you guys all take it seriously. Can you tell us a little bit about safety?
In all the chainsaw events that we do, it's ears, eyes, leg protection, every single one of them. If you don't have it on, you don't even get to run. So we take safety very seriously, especially when it comes to the hot saw, because if that chain comes off, it's going about 100 miles an hour, and it's razor sharp. It'll do some damage.
Okay, Kyla, thanks for coming on, and good luck in the competition.
Thank you.
1, 2, 3.
Did the competition with the saw carving. Anthony, thanks for coming on. Appreciate it.
Oh, no problem. Thanks for having me.
So where do you get your ideas for carving wood?
Well, this little competition came about from a show that Ben and I did when we were living in Florida down in Orlando. Yeah. So, you know, it kind of was pre-made, but a lot of it, you kind of just look at the piece of wood and see what you can come out of it. Depending on how the wood is shaped or where the knots are, you can use that to your advantage, or it might end up hurting you. But, you know, you have to see once you get cutting into the block.
Now, I noticed you made a chair. Do you make anything other than chairs?
I've attempted a few other sculptures. I can make little bears about yay big, but I haven't done them in a while, so it takes me a little while. And I've actually made a cactus before that was, you know, maybe 3 feet tall, and that came out really, really well.
So what do you like about actually the carving aspect of it?
It's kind of different. You know, it's pretty rustic and rough, but at the same time, there's a lot of little detail that goes into making the cuts right. You know, when you're using the chainsaw, it's, you know, it's a tool, so it's dangerous, but, you know, depending on how it goes in, you can mess it up or you can, you know, it can come out really well because of how much power, anything can happen.
Well, thanks, Anthony. Thanks for talking to us. Really appreciate it.
No problem. Thank you. Have a great day.
You too. Bye. Thanks. The vendors we have here at the event is Jim from Still. Thanks for coming on.
Thank you. Appreciate being here.
Tell us a little bit about what you have here.
Well, Still is a company that makes a wide variety of both gasoline-powered handheld equipment, mm-hmm. as well as battery, which is a large segment that is growing now, and electric products. Yeah. VR700, it's one of the landscaper choices, but also a lot of homeowners buy them due to the large yards we have in New Hampshire. But what is neat that we introduced last year was the BR450, and you can buy it with or without electric start. So if you're having trouble pulling over your equipment, simply by pressing this knob, it'll start your blower. So it makes it convenient and easy for your user if they have it on their back and they need to shut it off to speak with somebody or do something, they can restart it without taking it off.
Well, thanks, Jim. Thanks for coming on. I really appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Contestants, this is your cadence. 3, 2, 1, go!
There you go!
Pick your favorite and cheer them on, folks. It's not going to take them long. Dave Starlin, station number 7, got a beautiful cut going here. Young guy out of Columbus, throwing that race around. Using the whole 6-foot core, that's great. All right, White Sox is going around. Jesse, cutting gun down there? I didn't see you swing once, Jesse. A nice cut, man. There it is, Rob.
Good, how are you?
Thank you. All right, stick with him, guys. Ryan's favorite event. He's plugging away at that thing.
Yep, thank you.
Taking its lunch money. Station, fair enough. Nice cut, Ryan. Don't forget about the
round. Same spot. That's because of the wind, dude. 3, 2, 1, go!
It's your favorite cheer on the run, folks. One cut event. Oh, 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 oh. Stand number one and throw it down over there. That's not good. We're going to recut down there. That's transferring right off the bat. Let's stick with station 2 and 4. Who's going to be down to the bottom? And it's station 4. All right, stick with these late stations. There it is. Your cadence. 3, 2, 1, go! All right, folks, cheer it on. She's flying through that log down here on station 2. Cutting like no one's watching. Three, 2, 1, go! All right, folks, take your cheer them on. 7-pound razor blade swinging between their feet. They're going to cut 50% through the back. Fastest time's going to take 2 minutes. There's one at FLCC down in the Finger Lakes, Canandaigua, New York. There's another one at SUNY ESF right in Syracuse. If you're down that way this fall, check those out.
Out of gas.
All right, there it is. Give a big round of applause.
We're here with Ben and Jess, the organizers of this event today, along sponsored by the Hudson Historical Society. Thanks for coming on. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So tell us a little bit about it. It's a beautiful day today, and a lot of stuff going on. Huh?
It's the nicest weather I think we've had for the event in 4 years, and good competitor turnout with just about 50 competitors. Mm-hmm.
biggest show competitor-wise in New Hampshire and one of the biggest in New England.
Now, most of the people competing in this competition, are they just from, most of them from Canada and Vermont?
Nope. No Canadians made this trip, okay. But got Vermont, New York, Pennsylvania, Maine, New Hampshire.
Now, do you plan on having the event again next year, Jess?
Yes, we do. Hope to keep it as big and as great as it's going now. Get more sponsorship, get more competitors to come, and keep going.
Well, thanks for talking to us. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, that's the end of the 4th Annual Lumberjack Competition here in Hudson, New Hampshire, sponsored by the Hudson Historical Society. I'm John Latcher for my cameraman, Anthony DiMambro. Thanks for joining us, and ladies and gentlemen, start those chainsaws. Bye, everybody.